Hello everyone, welcome. This is chapter 2. In this chapter we will talk about UV editing and we will talk about how to apply textures and materials to our object. Basically, if you can imagine that we have a cube and there is an option here to generate UVs. I will uncheck this. So we have now, if you go to the UV editor, you will see that you have any UV editing. So what is UV editing? You have an 3D object and you want to apply a texture to it, so you should unfold it in a 2D space so you can put your textures or export that to in 2D printing software such as Inkscape and paint over this object. The first step is you mark seam, so you can imagine that is a paper and you want to cut it by scissors, so you can fold that correctly. The first step, you should check some seams here and Control E mark seam. It will be red, so you can select all and unwrap. If we go to UV editor, you will see that we have folded it correctly such as this, and you can now export it or add a texture to it. There is some options also. As you can see, I should now have an UV, but if you check on Smart UV project, it will make another projection. Assume that you have. Alright, so I will put the cylinder and you want to unfold it, so I will select the top to mark seam and the bottom to mark seam, select one edge and mark seam, then select all and unwrap. If you want to apply material, you should go here and apply. To end this step, you can apply new material to call it plastic. And you can edit your material as you like. The same here in the shader editor, you can apply or add nodes. You may apply or add noise texture, big color to color. You have a lot of textures such as wave texture, Voronoi, and so on. Or you can select add an image and select your image, maybe wood or metal. The same here and apply. I will go for shading, and as you can see, you have your preview such as this. And this is the noise. There is an add-on called Node Wrangler. You can go to the add-on and type Node and activate Node Wrangler. What Node Wrangler do is, if you can select a texture and click Control T to add mapping and texture node. So if you rotate that, you can rotate in X axis or rotate in Y axis or rotate in X axis. And you can also set the scale to be larger or to be small. Because this is black white, you can add it to the bump. And to click so the color may be yellow and it's metallic. And the roughness will be 0.1. I will add normal to normal and color to height. As you can see, it's you have now made the bump map. This is too tiny. Increase the scale to B4. And this is the bump map. In the scene, you can flip it or invert. Can change it by using Shift S and change the principle to be glossy, roughness 0.03, and click here to be normal. Or you can change it to gloss, Shift S shader to be a gloss. And the diffuse will be dull, so this is the glass. I think we should make it pure white. From here, you can change the world to be studio or and so on. Or change the rotation. This is only for viewport and it will not be shown in the render. This is the render and it's black because we haven't any light yet. We will discuss the EV in later section, but for now it's conclude. We have finished this lesson. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. See you in the next tutorial.